The next time you have a biodigester and you are going to construct it in a waterlogged area, I will want you to consider these tips coming up. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters, constructors of biodegradable waste toilet biodigesters in Ghana, and of course videos that explains how these biodigesters work and how they give homeowners that advantage in terms of managing their human waste. In this quick video, I'm going to show you simple tips that you can consider the next time you are going to construct a biodigester in a waterlogged area. The first key point to note is the footing of the building. Make sure if you are going to construct a biodigester, consider how high is the footing of the building. The footing of the building helps you to determine the type of toilet seats that you should use in the building. If the footing of the building is high, then you know you can consider using a simple air strap. But if the footing of the building is low, then I advise that you use the P-trap seat, which means that the pipes will go through the wall and then they will show outside before the bend will let it drop. That gives you the level that you need so that the biodigester is not going to be buried. The key part, remember, is how to manage the wastewater. So the outlet that you are looking at must determine where the wastewater is going. If you do get an inlet that's low, obviously your outlet must also go lower, which means that you are going to meet the water table. And if it's a water table which is high, then the problem starts for you. If there's water retaining in a biodigester, you are going to have the problem of the water affecting the biodegradation process and your biodigester not going to work well, which might lead to scent and smell and total biodigester rendering ineffective. So it's key you consider the footing of the building. So for homeowners, the advice is always to make sure that if you're going to build in a waterlogged area, or you know the water table in the area in which you are going to build your house is high, make sure you invest money in the footing and the foundation and raising the footing of the building high, so that when you do your filling and then you do the groundworks, there's enough laterite or sand that will help you absorb the water that will come during the rainy season, because then it means that the biodigester will also come up and then the top is only that will show, and the filling will help with the compound works, and then the digester will be buried nicely, and then you still have enough room for the wastewater. So that's key for you. So consider the filling in the house and then fill it to the necessary level so that it will help with the absorption of the water from the ground. The next key point is to raise the biodigester to a desired level. So the construction phase, make sure the foundation work is done for the biodigester wall, and then you do raise the biodigester up. The biodigester up means that the outlet water will also be up, and make sure you are sending this water out of the house. So you might need a bigger drainage system, or even if you are considering a soakaway or traditional soak pit, it must be at a place whereby it can help absorb the water. That means that filling of the ground is going to help you with the absorption of the water, and then the drainage system that you have will also send the water out, so that there's no water retained in the digester and the water is always going out. The outlet of the digester or the outlet of the wastewater must always have a bigger drainage system where you can go to. If you are using the soakaway, then consider having a submissive pump or a periodic pumping of the wastewater from the soakhole pit or the soakaway. That allows the water that is stuck in the digester to have a way